Hello students, so today we will start our class with one of the activity, a simple one. So that is, we are going to start the refraction concept. So before that, you can observe here, I have immersed a pencil in a transparent glass here. It is filled with water. So for instance, you know the principle of here, if I take out the pencil, am I not able to say there is a displacement of position of the pencil here. Same position, that means if light has been traveling, you can observe that, you can see the pencil a same manner. If I am immerse the pencil, same pencil in a water, I can observe that there is a displacement in its position, or I can say there is a bending of light takes place, isn't it? Why can't the pencil looks as if it was in a, when I took out the pencil from the glass. If I took out the pencil from the glass, the same pencil it will be. But when I immersed it, you can observe that there is some change in its position. Like it looks like somewhat it is bending. Why does this happen when only it is immersed? Not only you can take it as pencil, even when you place the coin inside the this glass, transparent glass, it looks like it appears bigger one, isn't it? Like that lemon if you immerse. So why are these happening? This is a concept where I will understand that there is a refraction of light takes place. Refraction is nothing but there is a bending of light takes place, because of that the pencil appears in this manner. So we'll discuss in detail about the concept which we have discussed. So that is refraction. So what is this refraction means? Refraction is nothing but bending of ray of light. So refraction is bending of ray of light when it travels from one medium to another medium. This is very important. One medium to another. When light is traveling from one medium to another medium, there is a bending of light ray takes place. So what is this bending of ray of light means? You know that what is the property of a principle behind rectilinear propagation of light. Now that is, rectilinear propagation of light says that light ray will continues to move in a straight line, isn't it? The light will not bend any way. It will be moving in a straight line. But there is one condition for that, means light ray will continues to move in a straight line unless it is have been moved to another medium. That means in an air medium, you will consider, if I take, this is a pen, this if I take, the I may able to see the exactly the pen because this is in the air medium. This is only traveling, light has been traveling in an air medium. For instance, this pen itself, if I immerse in a water, you know that air is different medium and water is different medium. Or if you take solid mediums, there are three states of matter, solid, liquid and gaseous. The light will travel different manner in different states of medium here. If I take air means, that is gaseous medium, that is different. If I take water, that is liquid medium. So the light ray may not travel in the same manner when it goes from air to water or water to air. Now if I consider the light ray is traveling in an air medium, that is one of the media we'll consider. Just an example, what I have taken. So this was the air medium. Okay, this was the glass, that is glass medium if I consider. The light ray has been traveling here. Okay, you observe that there is a bending of light takes place. So when there is bending of light takes place, why does the bending of ray of light takes place? You know that ray of light will travel in a straight line. But that ray of light will travel in a straight line unless it hits another one surface. Here it has hit the another one surface, that is glass surface, it has hit. When the light ray traveling in air medium, there is some speed of light. Why bending takes place means there is a speed of light. You know that there is speed of light, that is how much, what speed that the light has been traveling. there is different for the air and different for the glass. That means that is different for different mediums here. So if I take the speed of light in air medium, that is, we know that it is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. This is the speed of light in air, or we'll see it as a vacuum medium. This speed of light will changes. That means when I travel from air to glass, the pencil, when it shifts, that is when it traveling from air to glass medium, that speed of light will decreases. That means firstly it will be in 3 into 10 power 8. When it travels to the glass medium, its speed of light decreases and it becomes 2 into 10 raised to the power 8 meter per second. This is the main principle behind the refraction of light. Refraction means there is a bending of light takes place, where it takes place from one medium to another one medium. So I can say, what is the difference between reflection and refraction means? Reflection will go into, say, bouncing back of light ray when it is only in one medium. That is a very important. If you take reflection means, you are going to say light traveling here and it bounce back in the same medium, isn't it? If it is moving to another one medium, then that type of property is called as refraction. So reflection, if we write the differences, means reflection, that is taking place in one surface. Refraction, it takes place between two surfaces. That is, we'll say two transparent mediums. So why the refraction takes place? Why bending of ray of light takes place? Because there is a change in speed of light. That changes when light travels from air to glass medium, the speed of light decreases. So instead, from now onwards, I won't mention about air, glass. I'll mention about a specific term for this. That is, this is very important, rarer, and as well as I'll say about the denser. This is very important. You have to know what is rarer, madam, and also what is denser medium. So I'll say in briefly about the rarer and denser medium. So now let me take the three states of matter. So you know, solid, a liquid, and a gas. You consider gas means air, vacuum, everything will come. Liquid, water, kerosene, turpentine, oil. Solid means mainly it comes about quartz, glass, diamond, all will comes under the solid. That is only we are discussing about the here in the physics concept, what are the substances which come under solid, liquid, as well as gas here. So now instance, I'll compare with solid and liquid. You know that how the particles are arranged in solid, how it is in liquid, and how it is gassed. You know, particles are closely packed, very closely packed in a solid. It is moderately packed in a liquid. And in gas, they are freely packed. That is, they can move freely. So based on this, rarer and denser. You know that what is the meaning of dense forest? Dense means a thick forest. That means, for which one you will say more denser? We'll say that solid substances are denser medium compared to the other two substances, that is liquid as well as gas. So if I want to compare between solid and liquid, so for instance, I'll compare between diamond. Solid means diamond. A liquid means a kerosene, I'll consider. Okay. If I want to differentiate which is the rarer medium and which is the denser medium, obviously you will say that diamond is a denser medium, kerosene is a rarer medium. Isn't it? So for instance, air I'll consider. Air and kerosene, if I compare, which is the rarer medium, we'll say. So if we compare the kerosene and air, air will be the rarer medium, kerosene will be the denser medium. I think now by this differentiation, you can able to say which is the rarer medium and which is the denser medium. In the previous example, pencil example we have taken a glass here, isn't it? For that glass, I've taken a glass. For that glass, I have immersed a pencil here, so bending light takes place. Now, instead of telling bending of ray of light traveling from, there is because light travel from one medium to another medium, so there is bending of ray of light, and light travels from one medium, which is that one medium, from rarer medium to the denser medium, or the vice versa. Okay, there are two conditions here. Both rarer medium to denser medium. Rarer medium means air medium to glass medium, there is a ray of light travel, and as well as in some cases, ray of light will travel from denser medium to the rarer medium also. Okay, in that cases, what happens here? We'll discuss in detail.